If you see one of these and still call it a PowerPoint, you're not alone. Sometimes I even call it that, and I haven't used the program in years. I read that to break the cycle, all you need to do is use the correct wording 3 times in a row. So here it goes. Check out this awesome Canva presentation I made. Hey Matt, can you whip up a Canva presentation for tomorrow's meeting? I loved your Canva presentation. Will you share it with me? All right now, I've got a proposal for you. If I can show you how amazing Canva presentations are in the next 10 minutes, will you give it a try as well? Hi, I'm Cory, a marketing research and insight specialist here at Canva. In today's tutorial, I'll show you 6 simple steps to creating a stunning Canva presentation that'll keep your audience engaged and make you look and feel like a pro. I'll show you all the basics, starting with a template and making it your own with fonts, photos, and graphic elements. Then we'll explore tools and features like animation, cinematic effects, and recording your presentation. Last but not least, I'll show you the different ways you can collaborate and share your presentation. I'll even cover how to convert it to Google Slides, and dare I say, turn it into a PowerPoint. Jumping into Canva, you can bring up a range of templates by typing presentations in here. There are so many different styles to choose from, and each template has around 10 to 15 different page layouts. To view how many pages a template has, hover your cursor over it. This will also give you a quick preview of each page. If a play symbol pops up in the left-hand corner, it means the design includes page animations and timed slides. These features, along with the number of pages, can easily be changed later on. So don't base your decision solely on these factors. Pick a template that aligns with your content or brand or what you're trying to communicate. For example, this would suit a corporate presentation. And this would work well in a learning environment. Designs with the crown symbol are Canva Pro and Canva for Teams templates, or for students. The rest are free for all. For this tutorial, let's say I'm making a presentation for a government body in the environmental sector. So I'm looking for something earthy, yet professional. Perhaps add the word environmental to the search to narrow results. Now we're talking. This one looks perfect. Open it up and drag pages to include by clicking and dragging them onto the blank slide. Or you can hit this button to add the lot. To change the order, click and drag the page like this. Or pop into the grid view to move them around like this. When you're done, click it again to return to the standard view. Now I'll show you how to customize the appearance of your presentation. Let's say you're happy with the color palette, but you'd like to see a few different ways it could be applied. Head over to the Templates tab, scroll down to the bottom, and click Shuffle. Then keep clicking to see all the options. To change the color of individual elements, select it, hit the swatch, and choose your preferred color. You can find all the document colors listed up the top. And key colors from photos under this heading. Or click on the plus symbol to enter the color code or use the picker. Next, let's add text and change fonts. To add your own text, simply double-click on an existing text box and start typing. Or head over here and click this button. When the text is highlighted, you can change the font up here, along with other formatting preferences. I'd recommend sticking with 2 to 3 fonts for the entire presentation and only using display fonts for headings. For smaller text, select clean, simple styles and try to aim for a consistent look and feel. I'd say the same for colors too. 3 or 4 colors is normally all the variation you'll need. More than that starts to look confusing. All right, now let's move on to adding photos and other graphics. To upload a photo, open this tab. Click to add it anywhere on the page. or drag it over an existing image. It will automatically fill the frame. Hit this button to crop or reposition. Don't have your own photo? Don't panic, because Canva has a stock library full of high-quality images. Go to the Elements panel, type in keywords, and add it like before. Filter by graphics, or photos, or videos, etc., here. Select your favorite. Now resize it, move it, and reposition it in front or behind other elements. Now, if you're concerned about copyright, I'd suggest you check out this video with Matt that explains it all in detail. Any other questions, chuck them in the comments and we'll answer them there. Whenever you see a swatch over here, it means you can pick your own colors. On this next page, I'll add an animated graphic to create some movement. I'll use the same search term as before, only this time I'll use a filter, so it shows me just the animated options. Add it. Duplicate it. Nice, that gives it balance. Another way to give your presentation some movement is to add page animations. This will animate all the elements on the slide, which creates a cinematic look and feel when transitioning between slides. First, select the background, then click Animate. There's loads of different options. To preview an effect, hover your cursor over it. When you see one you like, click it, and you're done. Or hit this button to apply to all pages. And if you want to add a page timer, go to this icon. This will enable you to set your presentation to autoplay, but we'll talk more about that later because I have one more thing to show you. Similar to adding a page animation, you can apply special effects to elements as well. Click on the element you want to animate and head back here. It's the exact same process, only there are different animations to choose from. My personal favorite is pop. Now I've applied a couple animations, let's see how they look when I hit present. Nice. Most people love animations, but I'm guessing you're a little bit like me and know not to overdo it. You never want them to be distracting. All right, time to record my talking points over my presentation. Perfect for when you can't be there in person to present or to share with colleagues to watch in their own time. Head up to Share, click this icon and allow access to your mic if you haven't already. If you only want audio, turn the camera off by unchecking this option. I'm going to leave it on so you can see how it looks. Hit this button to start recording. And click End when you're done. If you're happy with how it went, save it. Or hit this button to discard and try again. You know, one of the best things about Canva presentations, what I really think sets us apart from the rest, is the collaboration. It's so easy. Let me show you how. I'm just going to add my team emails in here. They'll get a notification. And straight away, you can see everyone jumping in. You can follow their cursors and see what they're working on or looking at. It means there's no chance of both working on the same thing at the same time. They can leave comments on the slides, and I can respond just as easily. I can even leave them specific tasks on slides by calling them out like this. They'll get notified in Canva and get an email, so there's no chance of them not seeing it. Wow, it really starts to come together when you have a team working on it. Teamwork makes the dream work, as they say. This is something we use internally all the time. Whether it's building a presentation together, using a whiteboard to come up with ideas, or just getting an approval on your design, the collaboration aspect is just amazing. What's whiteboards, you ask? Check out this video so you can see how to use them with a team. Okay. Now it's ready to present. Let me show you a few ways to do it. If you're presenting to a live audience, simply hit Present and select one of these options. Use the standard mode to change the pages yourself. Or autoplay if you've added timers. To share your presentation with anyone who missed it, go back to the main panel and click this icon. Now you have a shareable link. You know what you could do? Make it a website. Sounds difficult. It isn't. Just hit this button. When it comes to downloading your design, there are a few options. For example, you can turn the presentation into a PDF or a series of images by clicking here and selecting PDF, JPEG, or PNG. Or save it as an MP4 video if it's got animations and audio. But say you have a colleague who is still using the old programs. Converting it to PowerPoint and Google Slides couldn't be simpler. To do this, go to More and find these icons. Hit this one and it'll download to your computer as a PowerPoint file, or this to transfer it to your Google Drive. If you haven't linked up your account already, you'll need to grant access first. Once that's done, save the file, open it up, and it'll automatically convert to slides you can download. You know what? There's still so much I could show you when it comes to creating Canva presentations, but I'd promise I could convince you in under 10 minutes. Am I under 10 minutes? Close enough. So did I convince you? What questions do you have? If you'd like us to make another video featuring more advanced tools and presentation tips, type more in the comments below. I could show you how to add music to your presentation, include video, make the presentations into a video, whiteboards, they're amazing to get your audience active and engaged, embedding social, live chat, remote control, oh, and magic shortcuts like this one. Did you enjoy this video? If you did, could I ask you one small favor? Hit the like button or share this with a friend who needs a bit of presentation inspiration. And comments, please ask your questions. I'll make sure I get back to you with an answer. And why not check out a few more of our videos? Here's my latest favorite. I'll leave you to it, but catch you next time.